So we're going to look at end behavior with regards to cubics now. So for instance, if we take the cubic x cubed minus 2x, as we go in the positive x direction, the y values go to positive infinity. So we would say the limit as x goes to infinity of f of x is equal to positive infinity. As the x values go to negative infinity, the y values also go to negative infinity. So we would say the limit as x goes to negative infinity of f of x equals negative infinity. Now if we switch the sign on the x cubed term, and we switch it to be negative, notice how the graph changes. In particular, notice how its end behavior changed. Now when we go to the positive x direction, the y values are going to negative infinity, so we would say the limit as x goes to positive infinity of f of x is equal to negative infinity. As the x values go to negative infinity, the y values go to positive infinity, so the limit as x goes to negative infinity of f of x is positive infinity. When that coefficient on the x cubed term is positive, we saw that as x goes to positive infinity, so do the y values. When the x value is negative, as in this case, as x goes to positive infinity, the y values go to negative infinity. That will always be true for cubics.